Welcome to another episode of My Life Experience. Guys, I'm excited today. I would like to continue where I stopped last week. Last week, I was talking about managing money, and I'll continue with that short-term management of money. Building your marriage on the foundation of trust. Doing your budget on the premise of transparency and accountability. Being transparent to each other. Making your budgets together, because it will bond you as a couple. You are spending time together. It is helping with your communication. Do it together. Even if the wife is not a working class, the husband, please involve your wife in all the decisions that you are making regarding money. I also said something on paying out your tithes, your offerings, make it as a priority on your budget every month. If you want to help people from the wife's side or the husband's side, set it aside on your budget and do that not in competition, but whenever there is need. Set aside money in your budget for some whatever offerings, whatever alms that you want to give out. Just put some contingency up, because you never lose a thing by being generous. I'll just refer to the Bible, the book of Proverbs, chapter 11, verse 24. It's saying that there is one who scatters, who gives basically, yet increases more, and there is one who withholds more than is right, but leads to poverty. So the Bible is so clear that sometimes people, they scatter, they give, yet they increase more. But the other people who are stingy, they withhold, and doing that, it leads them to poverty. So we cannot really struggle with that as a Christian. You should know already, the Bible is so clear. Put that money aside if it belongs to God or whosoever that you have committed to helping. The other thing that I want to say is pay up your utilities, pay up your bills. Put it on your budget that this is what we are going to pay this month. Prioritize, if you are in a rented house, prioritize the landlord. Give him his money. He's also got needs. That landlord has needs of their own. He's got their own family. And if he's got that house, it means he has need. He wants the money also. So please give him your share, their share of your money. Honor that. Give the landlord as per agreement. Don't make him wait. No, it's his house. Pay off your utilities. Your water. Pay off your water. Pay off your electricity. You don't want in the... at some point, your electricity to be cut and your water to be cut, then your wife will be going to the neighbor, asking for a bucket of water. It's so embarrassing. So just make sure that you budget for that. The water should be there, the electricity, the rentals, and all the necessary bills should be there on your budget. The other thing, a tip that I want to share with you is that when you are buying things, you are planning to buy your groceries, you are making your budget, make sure that the things are bought in bulk. All the non-perishable items that you may require in that month, like soap, buy it in bulk. Both washing soap and bathing soap, buy enough to last you for that month. You are buying sugar, buy it in bulk. You are buying salt, buy it in bulk. Everything that is non-perishable, buy it in bag. Also, maybe you can buy beans. You can buy in bag for enough to take you for a month or even more. You can buy, if you have got enough money to afford rice, you can also buy it in bag. You can buy dried fish, like for our, like us in Africa here, we've got a dried fish. You can buy the usiba, the small fish. Buy it in bag to last you for a month, up to at least to take you to the next paycheck, payday. You can also buy, we have dried vegetables here in Africa. You can buy those in a bag as well to take you to the next city. So that when you are within the month, you should not be totally out of food. You should not be totally out of stocks to use at the home. So in your budgeting, make sure that these non-perishable things, you buy them in bulk because it's cheaper. If you rely on buying on daily basis, these things, they become expensive. So it's important to buy it at the supermarket in bulk together, then you bring it to your home, you lock it up somewhere, and you just take it whenever there is need. As for the perishable items, the vegetables, the tomatoes, the onions, you can buy that maybe on a daily basis, on a weekly basis. Just keep aside some petty cash, some contingency to enable you buy those things. Yes, guys, those are the tips that I have on short-term budgeting. Another thing that I want to say is avoid impulse buying. Impulse buying is when maybe somebody just knocks on your door, is selling this, you, without even planning, you go ahead and buy. Somebody comes to your office with clothes without even planning for them. You, especially, I've seen that this is a problem that a lot of women have, that they just buy on impulse whatever they find. Buying like that leads to poverty because it's something that you haven't planned before. Only buy the things that you know that I've planned to buy these things. Another no to avoid is don't borrow on consumption. Make sure that you don't borrow on consumption. As newlyweds, the moment you start borrowing on consumption, just know that it's a sign that you are leading a borrowed life. The life that you are leading is not yours. You are living beyond your means. So, as a Christian, do not borrow on consumption. If you start borrowing on consumption, it's a sign that you should lower your standards. Go in a cheaper house, go in a cheaper location, change the standards of your eating. Whatever you're spending money on, you have to change and lower it so that you should live within your means and you stop borrowing on consumption. Thanks, guys. I hope it's been helpful to you. Next time, I'm gonna come with tips on how to manage long-term budgets. Thanks. It's nice talking once again. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button and the like, the thumbs up. Also, share this with your friends. Thank you, guys. Stay blessed. Oh,